Okay, so let us discuss Code Forces Educational Round 91. Although this was unrated, I did not actually give it. Let's try to solve some problems. I have read some questions. Problem B, I was trying, I've still not got it, but whatever I have got so far, I shall discuss. So first problem, three indices. You are given a permutation P1, P2, so on PN. So a permutation is nothing but a sequence of integers from 1 to n. Okay. Find three indices I, j, and k such that these two conditions are satisfied. So we need to find three indices. Can we apply three for loops? So n is having max value 1000. So three for loops is, I think it will give us TLE. It's not possible. So basically we just have to satisfy this within O of n square only. Maybe there's O of n solution, but I can think of O of n square. Let's see the test case examples. So basically what should we output? If we can find such three indices, we have to say yes and output any three indices. Multiple answers are allowed. If there are no indices, we have to print no. Okay. So what I was thinking was that first of all, O of n cube solution will not work because n is 1000, having max value 1000. So let us take the first test case, 2143. I need to find indices I, j, k such that this property is followed, and let's say A instead of P, A of I is less than, I'll write it here, A of I is less than A of j, and A of j is greater than A of k. So basically, let us start checking three numbers, 2, 1, 4. The property is not satisfied. We can clearly see that. Let's see 2, 1, 3. Again, property is not satisfied. What about 1, 4, 3? 1, 4, 3, the answer, yes, we can get from 1, 4, 3. Because 4 is greater than 1 and 4 is greater than 3. So essentially what I was trying to say, like, let us traverse the array, and when this condition happens, A of I is less than A of I plus 1. That means when we get a condition such that a greater number is after the current number, then let us run another for loop and check if there is any number smaller than this. Let me code and show you. I hope you understood, because see, in this example, 2, 1, 4, 3, suppose I'm here. A of I is 1. A of I is less than A of I plus 1. 1 is less than 4. Now I will run a for loop from j equal to I plus 2. I is over here. I'll run a loop from here. And I will check if A of I plus 1, that is currently this element, is greater than A of j. If it is, I will just break out and print those indices. So you can get the answer in O of n square only, and the number of calculations will become very less. I am using the CodeChef compiler. So let us see what is the input n and the integers. So int a of n comma I, I need one more variable j. Let's keep a flag variable, initially zero. Let us run a loop and check whether this condition holds true. If this condition is true, now let us check for the next condition. Next condition will be this. If this condition is also true, then let us make flag 1 and break. And if flag becomes 1, we can break. If flag is 0, we need to output no. Else, first output yes, and then output the indices. And remember, indices are 1 based. You can see here the answer is 2, 3, 4 because this is correct. So answer is 2, 3, 4. So it is 1 based indexing. So I plus 1 will be one of the indices. I plus 2 will be one of the indices. And J will be another index. I hope I'm correct here. Let us try for the sample test case. So over here, essentially these conditions are being satisfied. Instead of k, I don't need k actually. I can do it in 2 loops only. If you want to make an analogy of my code with these conditions, basically instead of j, I have I plus 1. Instead of k, I have j. So some time limit exceeded, I don't know why, 1 second. So what is the problem? Oh, okay. Oh, so yeah, J plus 1. Oh, it was some, this CodeChef compiler is sometimes weird. I don't know what happens, but yeah. So we are getting the answer. Multiple answers are allowed. As you can see, 3, 5, 6 is valid for this. I'm getting 1, 2, 3. Let us check if 1, 2, 3 is correct. Yes, 1, 2, 3 is correct. You can observe, you can verify, you can pause the video and see. So let us try and submit this. Hopefully it should work. Yeah, so it got submitted. So basically just reduce the 3 for loops to 2 for loops. and just check for this condition first. If this condition is true, then check for this condition. So essentially my I, J, K is nothing but I plus 1, J. Then print the indices if flag is 1. So that was problem A. Now let us see problem C. So I'll first remove this. And let us read problem C. Problem C, very short statement, so I think I can solve it. There are n programmers that you want to split. The skill of the ith programmer is AI. You want to assemble the maximum number of teams. There is a restriction for each team. The number of programmers in the team multiplied by minimum skill. Number of programmers in the team multiplied by minimum skill should be at least X. So we have two inputs, n x and then n integers. Okay. So number of programmers in a team multiplied by minimum skill. So let us see the first test case. I'll just clear this. First test case 7, 11, 2, 9, 5. 7, 11, 2, 9, 5. And x is equal to 10. I need to make maximum number of teams. So if I sort the array, 2, 5, 7, 9, 11. 11 is already greater than 10. So 11 is minimum. If I say I will make one team which has only 11, if one team has only 11, then what are they saying? Number of programmers multiplied by minimum among all programmer, minimum skill. So if I consider one team that is having only 11, then 11 into 1 is already greater than 10. So whenever a number is greater than or equal to X, I shall make that as one single team. Let us come to 9. 9 is not greater than or equal to 10. So I have to group it with some other number. Let us group it with 7. Okay, 7, 9. Now for 7, 9. So now my team is what? My team is now 7, 9. Number of programmers is 2. Minimum is 7. 2 into 7 is greater than or equal to 10. Yes, it is. So another team is 7, 9. One team was 11. Another team is 7, 9. Let us see 5. 5 is less than X. So I need some other programmer. Let's take 2 also. 2 is also less. So if I want to make this as a team, I will get 2, which is number of participants, into minimum is again 2. But 4 is less than 10. So this cannot be a team. So the answer is 2. Okay, so this was correct. Let us verify this logic for the second test case. So basically, I think it is just sorting. There's nothing much involved. So 2, 4, 2, 3. 2, 4, 2, 3. And X is 8. Yeah, X is 8. So let us sort the array 2, 2, 3, 4. Let us go from reverse, that is last element. 4 is not greater than 8. So I need someone else. 3. 3 into 2. 3 is minimum. 2 is number of participants so far. it is 6. 6 is not greater than or equal to 8. So I need some other person. Let us group these three. If I group these three, minimum is 2 and number of participants is 3, which is 6. 6 is not greater than or equal to 8. So I need to group one more person. Let us group one more. Let us say this is an entire team. There is only one team. So if there is only one team, number of people, 4, minimum is 2, which is greater than or equal to 8. Yes. So answer is 1. So I think the logic is working fine. Let us code and check now. So I'll take long int only. I'll just accept the input array. So I'll have to sort the array because I want to find maximum teams. Let me keep another variable j and a count variable and one more count variable. So for I equal to n minus 1, I greater than or equal to 0, minus minus I. So if a of I is greater than or equal to x, I can just do count plus plus. Count over here, count is my answer. So a of I greater than or equal to x, count plus plus. Otherwise what I have to do? Let me take a variable count 1. Count 1, this represents number of participants. See, basically over here I was checking how many participants should be there in a group. First I made only one participant, then I made a group of 2 participants, then 3 participants, then 4 participants. So I need a count variable to increase participants, right? So that is count 1. So count 1 is initially 1 whenever I am in this else part. For j equal to I minus 1, j greater than or equal to 0, minus minus j. If a of j into count 1. So basically I have to do count 1 plus plus. Count 1 plus plus means another participant has been added. So total participants now is count 1. Minimum is a of j. Why is a of j minimum? Because I have sorted the array. I hope you can understand why a of j is minimum. I have sorted the array. So suppose I am here, I is here, j is here. So j is minimum always. Whenever I'm traversing right to left, right. So I will always have minimum only with me. So minimum is a of j. Number of participants is count 1. If it is greater than or equal to x, I shall break. And if j is less than 0, sorry, if j is greater than or equal to 0, that means this loop was broken. If j is greater than or equal to 0, this loop was broken. If this loop was broken, I will make ij and I will increase my count. Why did I make ij? I will become j because until that point, I have formed a team. For example, until this point, I have formed one team. So that is why I need to make I equal to j. Otherwise, you will end up having TLE. You will have to keep calculating and you will get wrong answer also. So I equal to j is very important. You only analyze as to why I wrote this. I think it's easy for you to understand. But if you are facing problem, you can comment down. I hope you have understood so far. So I equal to j, and I have formed a team and I have increased the number of teams. Count represents number of teams. So ultimately what I should do, I should do this. That's it. So let us see. Yeah, the answer is matching with the test case. Let us check if I am correct. Yeah, so I was correct. So that was my solution. You can have another look. Basically, sort the array. Check if any element is greater than or equal to x. Directly increase the count. If it is not, then you need to add more participants. So for that, you need to have another loop. And in that loop, as soon as you get this condition, break. This condition means minimum number of participants, minimum programming skill into number of participants is greater than or equal to x. That is what we want. So if that condition is true, immediately break and make I equal to j. This is important. So that was the solution. And if I get b, I will do it. I did not try too much. I actually tried only A and C properly, like I thought about it. So I'll see you in the next video then. Please share this video and subscribe to my channel. And thank you. Bye.